rather me. I be high in the clouds with the system pumping loud. Tripping up in life is the illest you've been.
What we're gonna do right here is go back, way, way back.
Going way, way back to the early days.
Rockin' it. Got fresh
money, baby. You know how we do it.
Give it, party people, suck. Fuck you, don't listen to it.
Y'all ready for this?
Going Way Back Show with Money B.
Money B.
Classic hip hop.
Rewind.
Raw and uncut. Of course, I'm in the house with the usual suspects, that being the lovely Tyne Teezy. What up, Tyne Teezy?
What's going on?
And the homie DJ Always on
what
the ones
up,
and two, doing the do for you. And on the board, Shine is back there making everything right. I got to give Shine a shout out because Sean, I can't see anything on the screen, so I don't know if the public can see us.
I can see you.
Can you see me?
Yep.
I can't see me. You know, I'm so vain.
Yeah, I can see you just fine.
I can't see myself on the teleprompter, so I'm nervous right now.
You can definitely see you.
So we need to get that together. But, you know, I want to let everybody know, tonight is a really, really, really special show. We have a family member, you know, not just Digital Underground family member, my family member, Deon Big D Evans, original producer and DJ for Tupac Shakur. Now, the reason I say original, of course, he wasn't the first person that made a beat for Tupac. You know, shout out to like Ryan D, Chopmaster J, Shock G, you know, everybody worked on the demos or whatever. I say original, meaning that Deon was the first producer that Tupac basically allocated as his DJ and producer. He went out and bought a bunch of equipment. It was like, D, here's the equipment. I want you to make beats for
wow.
me. That was his job. You know, everybody else would make beats and give them to Tupac. But this was, Deon was the first person that was actually, you know, like,
That was his job.
That was his job.
Wow.
To make beats and do things for Tupac. And once he get, he's on his way. Once he get here, I got a few funny stories, if you let me tell them. About that, but you know, I call Deon family because I've known I'll call him Deon Big D, the Impossible. You know, some of you guys might know him as, but I've known him close to 30 years. We actually were in freshman and sophomore in high school at Berkeley High.
Wow,
way back in the day. So I've known this guy for a long time, and he actually lived like a block and a half away from me growing up. So we real tight, man. But, you know, not only was Deon a producer for Tupac, but he was also
the third. Please hold for Shock G. Yo, what's the deal? This the satin in your panties. That's right, the freak of the industry. Please hold for the piano man. Yo, what's the deal, y'all? This is Greg Jacobs. I did all the piano on Digital Underground and some of the Tupac stuff, too. And I wanted to let you know we're taking you way back on the Way Back Show with Money B, dude.
Shock G. It's going Way Back Show with Money B. And in the house, we have Deon Evans, Big D.
What up, though?
The Impossible.
Yes, sir.
Welcome to the show, brother.
Yes, sir.
Now,
thank you, Money B.
You know, I know you just got here, but you're already getting calls and people tuning in. And just for the specific reason that I have you on this show is because I'm always getting asked about these songs
right.
that, you know, and I'm going to be honest with you. You know, Pac was my guy, right. but, and we'll talk about this later.
Yeah.
But once he died, I stopped paying attention to what was being released and all of that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, I didn't produce it. So I don't know I'm going to be totally honest. I don't know. What was released, what was unreleased, what's a leak, or what's whatever.
Right, right.
Now, we just played, what did we just play?
Point the Finger.
Point the Finger. Was that an unreleased joint?
That's on Strictly for My Niggas album.
That's what, okay, that was.
Yeah.
All right, and, but somebody called, and they would hopefully call her if you call back. But, you know, before you got here, I was just saying how, basically, I've known you since I was like 14, 15 years old.
Yeah,
getting there 30 years in the game. Outside of family,
yeah.
Cletus Mack, I probably, you're the person that I've known in the music business longer than anybody.
Right.
You know, we lived right around the corner from each other, went
right.
to high school and whatnot.
Right.
You know, how tall are you, Big D?
6'7".
You 6'7", and I'm 5'3". I probably was like, he was 6'7" then, and I was like 5'1"
right.
back
right then.
Then
right.
So imagine me and this dude walking around
the
kicking
little
it.
Homie.
Yeah, that was the big homie. That was the big homie. We got
big
it
homie
in.
At that time. Yeah.
You know, and like I was saying, you know, I was telling him how, you know, I said that you were the Tupac's first producer. Obviously, you weren't his first producer, but
right.
I said that because Tupac actually bought equipment and was like, Big D, I need you to make beats
right,
for
exactly.
me.
Exactly.
That was your assignment. And then I hope you don't mind me saying, but it was kind of crazy back then because he's, you know, Tupac was a crazy dude.
Man.
So, and I'll let you.
You already know.
I'll let you elaborate, but, you know, Pac, he's the type of dude, like, when he wanted it now.
Yeah,
he's like,
exactly.
come here. So,
yeah, exactly.
I remember just being around and D didn't make the beat in time. He like, give me my equipment back.
Yeah, man.
What?
But then.
It was kind of like both of ours.
Yeah, but then the next day, he'd be like, D, I need you to make this beat. Come get the equipment.
Exactly.
So I'm like, would you make
Look,
up
I ain't going to be moving this stuff
goddamn
every day,
mind.
Man.
And then he set it up at his house, so right. D had to come over.
Over to the house to make beats. Like,
to
man.
Make beats. I need you to get over here and make this beat right now.
Well, at least it was set up.
Right, exactly. Like, man, come
yeah.
on, dude. Like, I mean, it's going to be a mile to your house, man. I mean, damn. I mean, say what you want me to do.
Okay.
Yeah, it was crazy. So, you know, I was saying that you work with a lot of artists. So just off the top of your head, can you run down a list of, outside of Tupac and D.U., other artists that people might know that you worked with, produced, or collaborated with?
Neo, you know,
obviously.
I gave him that name.
Did
I worked, you? Yep. I worked with Sticky Fingers. I worked with, I mean, the whole, basically, Onyx, like the whole little camp. I worked with, like, a, you know, Fredo Starr and, you know, shoot. I mean, like a lot of the Bay Area folks, you know what I'm saying, up there. You know,
Sido, Drew Down, the Loonies.
The Loonies, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, just people out here in L.A., like, you know what I'm saying? Like, with a lot of people out here. New York, Atlanta. I mean, I've been
Give
working.
Me some names, motherfucker.
Come on. He wants to say some names.
Yeah, you got
a name
ain't like
you're
telling
drop.
On anybody.
Yeah,
you got a name drop.
Nah, Big D, this is you, man. This is your show.
Nah,
so you got to let motherfuckers know that what you did.
Right, I mean, you know what I'm saying?
Say it with your chest, motherfucker.
Say it with your chest.
Say it with your grown man voice.
You know what I mean? Not just I worked with a lot of people out here, man. L.A., like Bo Rock. I worked with my homie DK. I would like a whole bunch of people, man. There's too many people to be naming, man. I know, but if you want a full like a resume on I had to put one up, like, you know what I'm saying? Cause like I gave mine a list of like songs I had that was out, but I worked with like Miguel.
Drop.
You know what I'm saying? I worked.
Yeah, say that shit.
I mean, a lot of people, man. They came. Like, I used to have a studio over in Studio City. Like, a lot of people came by. Like, you know what I'm saying? Damn, man.
You don't even remember.
I don't remember, man.
So many motherfuckers. Yeah, okay, man. Well, let's stick to the shit you know.
Yeah. So what's the name of your production company?
My company's called Demiac Entertainment. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that's been rolling for like, actually, I've been had it since 2005.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And I mean, I've never released anything, but I mean, you know, I'm trying to change that right now. But, you know, my publishing's back on Point Music.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Miss Yu. Miss Helen Yu's my attorney.
Okay. Helen Yu.
Yeah, so.
Yeah. I know Helen Yu, motherfucker. Helen Yu, motherfucker. I know you, Helen. Anyway, first song we're going to get into is Young Black Male, you know, because that was the first song on Tupac's first album, Tupacalypse Now.
Right.
Now, if you can remember, tell me about the process of making that song. Do you remember
there's a story behind that, man.
Okay, tell me about
it. Okay, you know, when y'all first got your little MPCs and whatever, your little S1000, I said, I want the same shit.
Right, right, right.
So basically, that's what Pac went out and bought for me. He went and bought me an SP-12. They gave me their SP-12. Fuse and Mun, they gave me their SP-12.
But let me say, I was the one that hooked this nigga up.
That's true.
With Pac, I was like, yo.
Yeah, let's get this straight. Everybody that don't know, if it wasn't for this nigga here, I wouldn't know Tupac.
Wow.
Seriously, this all this dude right
here. So he should be getting money half of that money.
Oh.
Cut the check, baby. Cut the check.
You were having them legal problems, too.
Okay.
Just the money, not the legal problems.
All right. So tell us.
They go in conjunction with one another, you know?
Tell us about the song.
Okay, though. Anyway, like I was saying, I had an SP-12 for courtesy of those guys, Raw Fusion.
Right.
And I had an EPS I bought, like, you know what I'm saying, when I was working at UC Berkeley. So anyway, I put together the beat for Young Black Male, you know what I'm saying, just sampled everything. It sounded bananas. I mean, it didn't come out good, but it was a whole different element.
Right.
So basically, I got the same day that the MPC 60. So I'll go and re-try to do the drums because, you know, Dave was working on the beat. And he had the fresh, clean MPC hi-hat, the cleanest hi-hat possible. I had the dirtiest, grimiest hi-hat possible, which made the record. You know what I mean? Nothing else really changed outside of that. But the hi-hat was the one that changed the record for everything.
Right.
So anyway, I go to the studio, and everybody's like, Pac's like, yo, that's it. And then I come back later. He steps out for like about an hour or two, and he comes back to the studio. And I changed the hi-hat around. He like, yo, man, what happened?
Damn, he noticed it.
Right?
You know what I'm saying? Because it was dirty at first. Now it's all clean and pretty. You know what I mean? So, you know, that was something I made in the studio, by the way. Like, you know what I mean? Like Starlight. Like,
she made it on the spot.
On the spot. Like, you know what I mean? One of them beats. Like, you know, we were just putting stuff together. I was like, he's like, give me a beat real quick. I was like, okay, cool. And I put that together. But like I said, when he came back, it was a whole different feel. So like, kind of turned everybody's nose down because everybody was just straight hating at that moment when they heard it.
Right.
But it worked out, I guess. You know, whatever. You know, the little war sample, whatever it was.
Yeah.
That I used on that.
We're about to get into that. And also, you know, just like I said, we just played Point the Finger, and we was talking about how that bass was rumbling, and I kind of. I almost think that was one of the Raw Fusion bass lines.
I was straight bitter. I took your little sine wave about the
S1000. Sounded like Raw Fusion.
Truth come out.
Here's the thing about it though. I didn't mix the record. That was Mo Preem and Mouse Man. They mixed that record, so that's why. Because I would have had the bass sounding different.
Right.
Like more so like a rumble like they have it today. Yeah. When you hear those basses. They had it like a little too compressed for me, but
it's dope though.
It worked out. No, the same. I heard it last night. I was like, damn, that sounds kind of actually all right.
All right, well let's get into this joint. I'm sorry. Did you want to say something? Always?
No, that's cool. That's the bass was killing.
Well, let's get right into the meat and the heart of Young Black Male, produced by Big D, right here on the Going Way Back Show. With Money B. What up? It's your man Money B, representing Digital Underground and Mask. And of course, I do it live with DJ Always, because we always on.
I'm trying to fact, but I can't affect.
a very rare Tupac classic.
All right, J-Mix, I'm going to have to get you that whole thing.
Okay. Well,
I got to get Big D to copy first, see what he want to do with it. But yeah, I just recently pulled that up. And of course, we heard the original changes, but like I said, it didn't really sound too different.
No, I mean, basically, like I said, they wanted to have that little late 90s feel, I guess, that when it came out, you know what I'm saying, on it, because I guess it came out in 98, 99.
Yeah, it had just a little more thickness in the bass line, but it was pretty much the same thing.
Right, it's pretty much the same thing.
Pretty much the same thing.
Scrub-ass singer singing on
it. So I know always going to be playing that version at the party.
Oh, yes. Definitely this version.
You're going to be rocking that now. So the next song that we're going to get into is one of my joints, actually.
Yes,
and
sir.
Like I said, you know, me and D, we've been making music for so long.
Man, what?
But the reason I'm playing this song, now this is from my Talking Dirty album, which was released in 2000, and the song is called 3N Theory.
Hey, hold on. Hold on before you go for further, man. Now, yeah. You know DJ Khaled got that song, No New Friends.
Well, that's what I'm about to get into.
That's the original.
This is Drake, right? Drake got the song.
Drake got the song, like, No New Friends.
Right.
I made this song 13 years ago.
Wow.
And the reason that I brought it up is because there was actually a little controversy within our clique when I made the song, because the song is 3N Theory, which means no new niggas. And I basically, you know, I wasn't like, man, I don't want to meet nobody new. I was just saying, like, you know, if you ain't already in my circle, I'm going to be leery of you trying to get in my circle.
Of course.
You know what I mean? Not like I don't want to meet you, but I got my core guys.
That's right.
Which is all family.
Which is all family. And I kind of believe that that's what Drake is talking about.
Right.
He's getting a little flack for that as well.
Right.
But it's funny that Shock G actually, you know, he reached out to me when he heard. He was like, man, you was way ahead of your time. You know, I didn't think people would feel it. That's why I was kind of resisting it back then.
He never had faith.
And I was just like, dude.
Shots.
Always have. Look, shots.
where's the good shots?
I got shots fired.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you know, sometimes cats wasn't feeling me. But, you know, I like to think I was ahead of my time. So
look at Nas in the
We could go on for days about songs that I've done that actually have right now just come the subject matter,
right?
You know, because I wasn't afraid to say what I was feeling.
Hey.
So let's rock up, just rock up, you know.
Let's get into it. Let's
a
go.
A few bars of this.
Let's go.
Y'all niggas really don't hear me. I got a 3N theory.
No new nigga.
Dog, I'm telling you sincerely about my 3N theory. Before you try to get in, check out my 3N theory.
No new nigga.
That's right, I'm shaking all bust. And I don't hang with the crew, cause I don't trust that many motherfuckers.
Check out this six kit, I wants to kick it, let's get lit. But who's this nitwit that's supposed to try to get with my program? You know how shit get. Credentials, movie essential. You got to have insurance like Prudential. Cause partner might be your folks, but to me he's quite unfamiliar. And niggas you don't know sometimes can kill ya. For real though, last thing I need right now is a Klingon that's gonna bring on funk from Fall Back. Nigga, this ain't Star Trek, but you gon' choose the boldly go.
Why you crying? I told ya, I'm tired of living life low. The rich can beat the lotto while the poor stay in the ghetto. The president elected, but I don't know how it happened. Better qualify for rapping with some disciplines of jacket. A day for Martin Luther King, now it's over with the rap. Turning over in the grave next to him is Malcolm X. Forgot too quickly, it makes me want to hate them. Forgot about his wisdom, he's the latest fascist statement. Red or blue, let's set you.
The original big nose rapper, Edward Ellington Humpty Hump Humphrey III. Please hold for Shock G. Yo, what's the deal? This the satin in your panties. That's right, the freak of the industry. Please hold for the piano man. Yo, what's the deal, y'all? This is Greg Jacobs. I did all the piano. I've been wandering around in some of the. This the original big nose rapper, Edward Ellington Humpty Hump Humphrey III.
Do we live in self destruction or escape from realism? They ask me why I'm angry because I'm tired of being kept down. My people let you. Wipe away the tears of a clown.
Back show with Money B.
Money B.
Look, we heard Tears of a Clown. Now, what's funny is, you know that song has been leaked, but that's not even the original version of Tears of a Clown, because when I thought about it, didn't Smoovy Smoove sing the hook?
That is Smoovy Smoove and Clever Jeff on the background.
Right, but I remember Smoovy Smoove did a version when he's going, Tears of a Clown.
I like Smokey?
Man, like Smokey.
Or Train, like Pokey.
Lord have mercy, like Okey.
Okey. Dog.
Like Dopey. Oh,
okay. Dopey. Hey, hold on. We got to elaborate on this a little bit more.
Man, please tell me about it.
Man, the studio session on that one was so crazy. So I'm in there, you know what I'm saying, in the control booth. And then me and Clever Jeff and Darren Harris, the engineer, was in there. And so Smooth was drunk.
Right.
And Pac, I guess he's drunk too. So they're in the booth. Next thing you know, hey Smooth, you gotta have a roll you up.
Say what?
He told Smooth we gonna roll him up.
Really?
He told him I'm gonna roll you up, you'll get out of my session. So that it was just so funny.
There's always funny stories about that dude. I heard one.
Smooth?
The same guy that was in the room with no clothes on.
When?
Was he on tour with you guys?
Yeah, he was on tour originally.
I heard a story about him when you guys were on tour. Somebody was sharing a room, and I'm not sure if it was you or who, but he was laying across the bed with no clothes on. You walked into the room and was like, what the hell are you doing?
I don't remember that. Clint is back. What up, Dre?
Big D.
How y'all doing?
Man, my dude, what is it?
How you guys?
Yeah, nah, but you know, like I know that song Tears of a Clown was leaked. And I'm not sure if they even had, like I said, that was another one that I just recently found on one of my cassettes. I pulled.
The quality on it so bad though, so like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't know, but I would love to get a copy of that original version.
Oh, yeah.
With Smoovy Smoove.
Oh, yeah.
Doing that, Clee, you remember that when he's going, Tears of a Clown.
Clee needs a mic. You need to sit right in that seat right there.
If he feel like it, you know.
He feels like it.
If he want to. I mean, you know, Clee is a part of this history.
No pressure.
Exactly.
If he want to get involved.
No pressure.
No pressure. No pressure. No pressure. No pressure.
Get in there.
You know what I mean? All right.
Don't act like you don't want to.
Yeah. So we're going to keep it moving. Now, J-Mix from Tupac Nation had just asked about the whole break them off thing. Now, and Big D,
yeah.
I'm going to need, I know I did it, and we did it, but I don't remember why we did it, because we did two versions
right.
of the same song.
Right.
That was for our artist Debbie, she was out of San Diego, and of course, now both of these songs, they were leaked by me, actually, you know, like a few years ago.
I never heard anybody drop their own leakage.
He's just telling on himself.
Well,
drive.
I don't give a fuck. Yeah.
It's out right now in the stores.
Yeah, we was talking about the I don't know if you call them clairvoyant, but the artists that just work like that, that get it done. I'm gonna tell you, the mechanics, Forex and mechanics, as far as production, they whip them out like that, just like Pac and Neo.
How they write
that quick, they produce that quick. So Forex, we about to try to get a couple more calls before they push us out of here.
Forex, I'll let you know, man.
All right, one love.
770, you're on the line.
Caller.
Yo, this is Huey.
What Huey, up? What up, though?
Hey, Huey.
That's my brother right there, Huey from the A.
What up, Huey?
Nothing, man. Just admiring my PIC, man. I just can't do nothing but show much love, much respect.
Man, thank you, sir. You know how we do it, man, all the time. All the time.
Oh, yeah.
That's what's up, Big D.
We rock with him in the A.
Yeah, man. This is my boy from, you know what I'm saying? You're out in the A, man. You got to mess with my PIC, though, man.
Saying, Big D, he got a fan base.
We can't hear you.
I said Big D got a fan base that spread, like you said, from the Netherlands to the A.
You know what I'm saying?
To Oakland. You're international, brother.
Man, what?
Thanks, Huey, for that.
And it is crazy is that you've had such a career. Everybody knows you, and I'm just, you know, I just want to be one of the cats to help put a face on it.
Thank you, sir.
You know what I mean? Even though I was like pulling teeth trying to get a picture of your ass.
didn't find one.
He was like,
I ain't got no picture. Look, I don't even have no picture, really.
He's like, fuck that shit.
He said, that's why I'm behind scenes making it happen.
Yeah, I mean, exactly.
We got a call from 818.
818.
Yo, Money B, what up, man?
What up? Who that?
Yo, this is Mexicali, man. I just want to say what's up with Deon real quick, man.
What's going on?
Hey, Deon, man, I appreciate all the music you've done, man. It's like, dude, you know, growing up to Pac, man, to me, he's still the best rapper to this day, man. And to the day I die, it'll still be the same way, you know?
No, I feel you, dog.
And it's like, you know, most of all the music that I've heard with you guys is like, it's classic, dude. You know what I mean? They don't make music like how they used to back in the days, dude. And the work that you did with them is classic, you know? Hey,
thank you. We appreciate
digital
that.
Digital and all that, man. I appreciate that, man. It's, you know, especially the unreleased, what was that one? Tears of a Clown. That's crazy, man. I've been bumping that since the first time I got it, like, 98, something, you know?
Yeah, man. I appreciate it, man. I mean, there's still a lot more unreleased stuff. You just, you know what I mean? It's just, you know, you gotta do it how you gotta do it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, keep tuning in, because I'm going to be leaking them.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, he
and tell a friend.
No doubt.
And then tell a friend, tell a friend. Until
I start charging for these
motherfuckers. You ever gonna hear that in good quality?
Oh, yeah, all the time.
No, is there a place?
No doubt, man.
He said it's a good quality.
Hey, I just want to tell you, I got nothing but love and nothing but love and respect for all you dudes, man. No doubt.
One love, Mexicali. Appreciate it. Thanks for calling.
All right, Mexicali. Peace.
Thank you.
Now, before we get out, you know, we did in that last segment with Heartbreaker, which was Klee and John Doe, and we actually got Klee in the house. Klee, you've been laying back in the cut. Now, I just want you to give me, you know, from your standpoint, just tell me about Big D, you know, the whole journey, you know what I mean?
Man, Big D is that dude, man. You know, when I was 14, 15 years old,
you know,
I had the opportunity to go over to a super producer house, and he's like, you know what, you dope. Come on, I got this for you. And he called me and be like, Klee, get this done, and Klee, get that done. So it was important to me. Just to have that type of person that was around me, that, you know, that played that type of part in my life, and watching, I got to watch everything he did, though, you know. So I would sit over at the house with him, because I'd be over your house, and then I just wandered down when y'all lived in the same building. So I just wandered downstairs and go hang out with Big D watch him produce major hits. You know what I mean? I got to sit there and watch that shit being made, and it was big, you know. But Big D always been the dopest, man. I always been riding for him. You know, it was mandatory that I fuck with him.
Thank
constantly.
You.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Now, before we get out on this last song, Big D, I want you to tell everybody where they can find you, you know, whether it be social network or just if they want to contact you about production or if they just want to know what you got going on. Give us all that information right now.
No, for sure. Before I do that real quick, let me just say a couple what's ups to my, you know, my folks, like my boy Hugh just called. That's my partner for
Shout
real.
Shout him out.
That's my partner for real. My boy A-Town, Boku, my brother James, brother Steve, you know, DD, you know.
James, what's up, Big James?
You know what I'm saying? And all my nieces and nephews, you know what I'm saying? And Akira Kai, I can't forget my kids, man. Damn.
Akira.
But you can find me on Facebook, Deon Evans, you know what I'm saying? You'll just go through the picture, you'll see me. Who else you can find me on? I got a Twitter. I ain't active on Instagram and that other stuff, man, but you know what I'm saying? Basically, if you want to find me, or you can get at me at bigdevans@gmail.com. You know what I'm saying? So we out here, we trying to grind, we trying to get it in. We still making beats, you know what I'm saying? We doing whatever, like I do whatever, you know what I mean, as far as production. So you got some kind of budget, holla at me.
That's what it do. Keyword, if you got a budget.
Budget.
Fuck with my guy.
I don't need to establish any more artists. I know too many people.
We're already not breaking nobody.
No, not at all.
For real.
Breaking or losing nobody.
Now, you know, let me give a shout out. Shout out to Sean, because he's looking out. He's taking care of us. You know, we had a little technical difficulty, but he's a champ. You know, like, you how many weeks you been on the job?
Four.
Well, really more like two.
Like 2 weeks, like, by itself. But, you know, this, you faced some adversity and you held it down.
That was a fast turnaround.
You stayed calm. You didn't shave your beard or nothing. You was all right.
You know, last week cool I trimmed it after the show.
Yeah, you trimmed it.
Because I felt so self-conscious.
Right. But it's still the same length. I like that you didn't trim it anymore.
That is hilarious.
So the beard stayed intact. The show kept moving. So shout out to Sean.
Great job, Sean. Great job.
You know, we've been playing music, and I know that we've been like playing songs for like 60 seconds and playing in the middle. If you really want to hear the whole songs or most of the songs that we've been playing, you have to tune into the actual podcast, which we just picked up a new affiliate, Gecko Brothers.
Nice.
Radio.com. That's GeckoBros.com. No, Radio.com. I'm sorry. And that's every Friday night, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Of course, I'm on rapstation.com. which is Chuck D's radio station. That's every Sunday night, 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And skyradio.com. That's on Saturday nights, 7 p.m. But if you get confused, always go to goingwaybackshow.com, where you can check out the archives of everything that we do. If you want to just holler at us personally, you can catch us on social media. Ton Teezy.
At Ton, T-O-N underscore T-E-E-Z-Y. Also, on those podcasts, you would definitely get the old school new news, because we didn't get it tonight.
Yeah, we had so much information we wanted to get out of Big D. We didn't get the old school new news. But if you want to hear this week's old school new news, definitely check out the podcast on either of those stations, or check out goingwaybackshow.com and pick it up. Always.
I'm at Always In Your Ear on Twitter.
In Your Ear.
In Your Ear. And you can also find me on Facebook, too, at Ryan Always page.
Now, Always, I never really even asked you. Are you spending any clubs here in L.A.?
Not right now. I've been just traveling around. I was in Palm Springs this past weekend for the PIP event. I'm going to Vegas tomorrow with Speedy to do another event. So.
You know, Always DJs for Reach Around Radio, and you also do a little bit of work for MC Light as well, right?
Yeah, I've worked with Light here and there, doing and setups with her, and my partner Dano works with her a lot too, so.
Okay.
But yeah, I've, you know, and just try to stay busy.
And for Tisha and
Tisha and Dwayne Martin.
Dwayne Campbell's Club.
Yeah. What's the name of that club?
Zen.
Zen.
Tonight they're doing Indie Night, Indie Film Night.
Okay, so if y'all in L.A., catch Always. And of course, myself, it's at MoneyB69. That's for everything. Yo, you know what I mean?
Let me give a shout out to two more people I forgot, man. You know what I'm saying?
Shout them.
Helen Yu.
Nah, my man. I mean, that's my people, man. But anyway, Bobby DeBarge Jr.
Bobby
got a single out on him right now called I'll Be the One. You can go look it up on Vivo. Buy it on iTunes. Also, my man Ray Blaylock, one of the dopest writers. Right outside of Neo. Like, everybody compare him like to Neo, but to me he got his own swag, a little different than Neo, but he's dope as hell.
So basically, we heard it first here. What's his name again?
His name is Blaylock.
Blaylock. So when y'all hear about Blaylock, be like, you know what, Big D.
Yeah,
here first.
Definitely.
Was talking about it.
And thank you all for all the participants in the chat room. Much love, especially to our faithful Diella.
Diella, what up, Diella? So like I said, you know, at MoneyB69, that's Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and then also like the Going Way Back Show fan page on Facebook
and YouTube.
And YouTube,
and
Going
YouTube.
Way Back Show.
Subscribe.
But like I said, always when you feel lost, just go to goingwaybackshow.com. Now we're gonna get out of here, and this is kind of like a treat for my guy Big D. You know, you treated us for your presence being in the studio.
Oh man,
but
nothing.
You know, we were talking. Like I said, I grew up with Big D,
man,
and from the beginning, you know,
so
throughout everything, I would just hang out at this dude's house, and we would just make songs and do demos, and like I don't even know if we even considered releasing them. We just wanted to do music together.
Right.
So we would do songs. So Big D, when I talked to him the other day, he was like, "Yo, you got this song, you got that." I was like, "You know what? It's crazy. I just found it on a damn cassette." And this is a song I actually forgot that I did.
You're gonna have to put those cassettes in a safety deposit box.
I will.
Real.
I will.
Real.
Well, that's why I'm digitizing everything right now.
Right.
Because I'm just going through. And let me just say, another crazy thing is I was going through cassettes, and I actually found a cassette of, you know, it said like Digital Underground, Raw Fusion Performance, 1992, Gary, Indiana.
Wow.
And so I was like, let me listen to it. And when I listened to it, it was a show that we did like 2 days after the Rodney King riots.
Wow.
And we were talking about it on stage, and we were reporting about, because in the Midwest at the time, you know, they weren't saying what was really going on, because they didn't want everybody to feel
get riled up exactly.
to do it. Yeah. So they was like, you know, on the news throughout the country, you would say, oh yeah, 30 guys got arrested. I call home and they be like, yo, two cops got shot in Richmond last night. They did this, did that. So they wasn't giving the real, and I just remember that. And it's funny, I'm running across all of these songs.
These tapes, yeah.
So this song is a treat to Big D, because he actually asked me about it. This is a song we did probably around 1990-ish, and Big D was still living a block and a half away from my mama.
Alcatraz.
And this was like a four, you know, Alcatraz. In Berkeley. This was a four-track song that we did, and it's called Money California. Produced by Big D.
Money California.
So let's run that.
Wow.
And let's hear some of it. And you know, until next week, people, be easy. This is the Going Way Back Show with Money B.
Money
Stay
B.
tuned.
It's the Going Way Back Show with Money B. Classic hip hop, raw and uncut.
Kick back and tell you how it is. Something really stirring. I got a letter, they came in around the other day. It was from my cousin in Philadelphia, PA. It said, how are you, Ron? Yes, the family's doing fine. But the big city life has not been treating me so fine. See, crime and poverty suck me in if I don't move. So after thinking it over, this is what I plan to do. Pack my bags and move out to the Golden State to live the good life, no strife. I can hardly wait to spend my days laying up under sandy beaches, girls in bikinis. Yes, life will be a bowl of peaches and real sun. I have to find some palm trees and catch a breeze, but in my mind I'm thinking ninja please. But I read all, cause the hammer sounded so fly. We had a vision of fast times like Bridgemont High. His last remark was peace, love, and see you soon. Because to him, life in Cali was a big country. And so I wrote my cousin back before he wasn't gone. You see, this is sun, but it's really Money California. I got the word for the day. I got the word for the day. I got the word.
It's the Going Way Back Show with Money B.
I got the
classic hip hop, raw and uncut.
Okay, class, pay attention, give me for while I'm speaking. You're tweaking cause you want to know the word for the day. I'm giving a couple of boots, so no Tuesday coming Tuesday. And I heard about a third that can make the spider moves. It's a noun that can be found attached to a body where a hottie makes a lot of scurry, scurry, scratch them. Stop the beat, drop the beat while I sing. They do run, 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 they do run 10. So get the point, get the point, get the point, get the point. It's the joy that keeps them flexing kinda wicked. Without them I couldn't pick it. Oh, brr, stick it, ha, 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 stick it in the living room. Hey, they look great behind the head.
Word.
Silky like a quilt, they can be spread across the bed.
Right.
And if you like it, you can bite it without making a mess. If you ain't already guessed, I say the word for the day is lit. So everybody say spread the word. I said the word for the day is legs, so what you say? Okay, the word for the day is legs, so all my niggas say spread the word. Yes, the word for the day is legs, so what you say?
I love the legs, but I won't beg. Get the gal plays Peg Bundy and Sister Al. You get none. See, I'm the man and I got a plan. When it comes to that, for instance, and to elaborate, let me call and clean my assistant.
Well, thank you, Mr. Brooks.
Please continue, Mr. Askey. Kick the shit about the chick that would not let you pass through.
Well, one the other night, I pulled the tight one. Even Ray Charles could have seen she was the right one. Last night, I was bored, and so I went and found the number.
I called
the ditch, and I said, yo, I wonder if I said let's get naked, would you feel disrespected? She said no, she was flattered that she'd been feeling neglected. Now, in my mind, I'm thinking she's too fine. She's lying to me at the same time. If she's lying, she's dying to cheat. Great, we got a date, shouldn't be no obstacle. The ghost, she said, clearly when I come, I got a surprise for you. I said, be here by 10, and then she said, no problem. She knocked, I said, it ain't locked, just turn the knob. She came and could I go in, is what I was asking. But
it's the Goin' Way Back Show with Money B. Classic hip-hop, raw and uncut.